And I'm bleeding here. I'm bleeding here.
Okay.
I'm bleeding here.
Can you call the hospital? Get ambulance?
I need an ambulance fast. Get me to the hospital.
A horrific attack. U.S. Ambassador to South Korea Mark Lippert slashed in the face and arm by a man with a history of erratic behavior. A month and a half later, he wears a brace that looks like a bionic arm. Lippert's doctor said his injuries could have been life-threatening. North Korea wasn't involved, but praised the attack, and now is willing to go one step further. A North Korean propaganda arm says of Ambassador Lippert, quote, if he doesn't watch himself, in the future he might have to deal with something far worse. Lippert's offense to North Korea? Saying simply that if Kim Jong-un's regime wants better ties with the West, he should take steps to end his nuclear program. One analyst says Kim needs to be held accountable for that threat.
When his press statements come out threatening the life of an American ambassador, he looks like he's the head of the mafia.
From the State Department, a muted response. Officials saying it's the same old rhetoric from North Korea, that Ambassador Lippert's security won't change from its elevated posture following the knife attack. But a former ambassador to Seoul says even if North Korea doesn't carry out the threat itself,
the real danger would be some sort of lone wolf who feels he is acting on some kind of overall instructions. So I think that is the concern.
This comes at a time when seemingly every utterance from Kim, every move he makes, is calculated for public consumption. He was just photographed atop Mount Paektu, the 9,000-foot peak where, according to North Korean lore, his father Kim Jong-il was born. Many historians believe his father was actually born in Russia. One expert says this photo op could be a sign of palace intrigue, that Kim still needs to show he's in charge.
Contrary to the myth that Kim Jong-un has now finally consolidated his power, even after killing his uncle, I think this man is more threatened by generals and some of the elite. He's afraid of a coup than ever.